Breaking news. Trump has made his first appointment. Susie Wiles. So when I first briefly glanced at this person, I thought, huh, that's odd. Maybe that's a real female. And then I went about my day. And then I thought, well, let me just take another look here. Let's take a close look. So this is the new White House chief of staff. So-called Ice Maiden. Propelled Trump to victory. And his new chief of staff. There's the Ice Maiden. Hard to tell, is that a man or a woman? A lot of that going around these days. And let's get a little background information. I think this photo is quite indicative. Kind of got that Benny Hill look. Susan Summerall. Offspring of NFL commentator Pat Summerall. Remember him? Back when I used to watch football. Former NFL player, sportscaster. The offspring of a famous media personality, a sportscaster. That kind of makes sense. Part of the system. Donald Trump appoints Susie Wiles as first woman chief of staff. I'm going to disagree with that statement. Not so sure about this word woman here. Take off the W-O and I think you got yourself a man. Now you got to be able to see this for yourself. You do have the right to remain deceived, as do most of the people in this world. And most people choose to be deceived, so there's really no point in me even making this video or any video. Most people will remain deceived because they love the narrative. Who doesn't love the Trump narrative? Very exciting, very positive. Almost had me fooled there for a minute. Now, I knew he was going to get the popular vote, but what surprised me is that they actually seem to have counted the votes this time. I thought they would pull another 2020 and just kind of make up a bunch of numbers, but these numbers probably were accurate. And, you know, something really strange about government. I think there's a lot of supernatural things happening with government. There always has been, in fact, throughout the ancient world, and I don't think it's changed. Because in the ancient world, the kings were considered demigods or God's representative on earth, which is kind of what Adam is portrayed as being, you know, the image of God, right? Even the ancient Near Eastern kings were the image of their gods, different gods. They were the image, the living, breathing statue. Just like we have the host of heaven, the spiritual entities, we have the host of earth. You know, they worship and serve the host of heaven, in fact. I'll put the verse up on screen. I just read it today in the book of 2 Kings. I might even do a separate video on that. I'll put that on YouTube. I do Bible study videos on YouTube if anyone's interested. So just ask yourself, look closely, is that a man or a woman? Now, it's obviously not dressed like a man. In fact, I've seen people looking like this in San Francisco before. All right. Think Tootsie. Think Church Lady. Think Austin Powers. Kind of like when they dress up actors in the movies to play a woman. That's kind of what's going on here. Now, this doesn't fit any existing narrative or counter-narrative. Nobody seems to want to talk about this because it's kind of outside the box, but it's true. So that's what truth is. Truth is outside the box. As we live in a world full of lies, and people actually prefer the lie. When I see this, this looks like Benny Hill to me, okay? Now, maybe some of you transvestigators out there will say, oh, Benny Hill's a woman. I don't know. That's not the point. I'm just saying it looks like one of these pudgy dudes, all right, in drag. I think we all know a pudgy dude, and just imagine them in drag. That's what you got here. It's something about the eyes. You know, there's just a masculine frame underneath the hair and the makeup. Like this one here is quite obvious to me. It's very obvious. I mean, this could be a Saturday Night Live skit where a famous actor dresses up like a woman and everyone laughs because they know who it is and they know the characters in drag. What it is this is a shaman. This is a shadow queen. This is a cult functionary for the host of heaven. This is a spirit medium practicing the occult to help Trump, because Trump's the king. The king needs a spirit medium, a prophet. The king needs someone to connect him to the host of heaven, otherwise known as the aliens, all right? Now, that's a bit of a loaded word because people think, oh, you know, science fiction movie, alien. No, spiritual entities from the other realm. Angels, if you wish, if I really need to keep it simple. Or demons. The government works for the demons, and they need a spirit medium to channel the communication. And they use androgynous people like this, the androgyne, the people who practice ritual androgyny. All right, that's just how it is. And I guess we're not supposed to know this. Now, I never heard of this person until now, but it's been around. This one worked for Reagan back in the day. Some of these is kind of hard to tell. That's a good one. They kind of softened up the face a bit. That'll fool you right there. That one won't fool you. That one might fool you. It doesn't fool me. And don't blame me if you're fooled. It's not my fault. This might be a good thumbnail, in fact. Yeah, sees the smile, all right? I've told you guys about this 1,000 times. They have the smile, which kind of makes them look more feminine if they smile like this. However, not quite good enough, right? Doesn't quite cut it. Look at this one. Look at that. Come on. That's the 6-footer. All right. That's the 6-footer. They say it's 5'11". No, these are 6-footers. They take off an inch in the media to try to fool you. Doesn't look so bad. See, they get these short, pudgy dudes. I don't know where they come from. Yeah, it's a short, pudgy dude. That one will fool you, though. That one right there. This one will not. That doesn't fool anybody. That's the cold, hard stare of the transvestite. You don't see women. That's why they call this one the Ice Maiden. They're saying, oh, this is one of those tough women. No, it's a dude in a dress, all right? Not even a dress. It's a dude in a monochrome pantsuit. Oh, that's the Ice Maiden. No, that's a man, all right? It's very simple, actually, very simple. And again, don't get me wrong, I do have conservative values. I probably have very similar values to most Trump supporters. What values do we share? We share a lot of the same values. Speaking of aliens, they might be aliens, or at least they're in contact. It kind of reminds me of someone I know. I know a guy, you know, who's kind of pudgy, and if he put on a wig, bit of lipstick, he'd look a lot like that. I got another 6-footer. They're 6-footers. They're not 5'11". And who is the other one? Ivanka. Where's Ivanka? Ivanka should have been there. And did you see Barron? Barron's like 8 feet tall. Speaking of the descendants of the Anakim, there's another Ice Maiden, right? Melania. Now look at this. The hips are way too wide. They overdo it. They never know how to do it just right. They overdo it. Those hips are ridiculous. Maybe it's a joke. It's like an inside joke. They're overdoing the hip pads. Again, Trump is 6'2", all right? Why are these women also 6 feet tall? What's going on there? When did that ever happen? I've met 2 women in my life who have been 6 feet tall, and they're both from the Netherlands, which are the tallest people in the world. The odds of one man, or whatever he is, being surrounded by all these 6-foot women is impossible. Now look at this one. Remember this? This is Donald Trump's niece. No, that is Donald Trump dressed up like his niece. That's Donald Trump right there, dressed up like his niece. Remember that? That was a few years ago. Something really strange going on with these people. Something weird. Something supernatural. It's the Benny Hill Show. All right, we got the Kennedy Beacon from May 9th, 2024. Operation Warp Speed. This is on Substack. It's the Kennedy Beacon. That's a good one, too, right there. Look at this. Remember, Trump helped create the jab. Trump went along with the jab narrative, Operation Warp Speed. He didn't do anything to stop the lockdowns. He didn't get shot. Now, there could be some kind of, how do I say this without raising any flags? There could be a narrative, another narrative involving an assassination attempt that could be a successful narrative. You know what I'm saying? Could be the alien narrative could intensify, especially if Musk is part of his team. So that could be later on in his presidency, the alien narrative. You know, digital currency, whatever. There's going to be some kind of big psyop at some point in the next 4 years, most likely. Unless they just want us to have a good time for a few years to take a break and to forget about all the bad stuff. I don't know. remember what happened in the fourth year of the previous Trump administration. What happened in the fourth year? Well, Trump kind of stepped down, it seemed like to me, and Fauci took over. Trump really didn't do much other than Warp Speed and Space Force. So, make America jabbed again. So a friend of mine thinks that we'll have 3 good years and then some major psyop will happen in the fourth year again. So maybe that's what's going to happen. I don't know. It'd be nice to have 3 good years. I mean, that would be nice. I could use 3 good years. I don't know about you. Maybe that's asking too much. Make Big Pharma rich again. That's pretty good. Why does Trump continue to demand acclaim for his role in pushing the shots through? Good question that the Trump supporters have totally forgotten about. We find the answer in Susie Wiles. That's the subject of today's video, who appears to be the connective tissue between Trump and Big Pharma. There you go. Politico published a lengthy profile identifying Wiles as the most feared and least known political operative in America, otherwise known as the Ice Maiden, currently serving as Trump's most important advisor. All right. Why is that? Because it's the spirit medium, otherwise known as the Shadow Queen. Wiles became co-chair of lobbying firm Mercury, one of those host of heaven type deals, a wandering star. Mercury, of course, associated with Hermes, which is a messenger to the gods, something like that. Mercury's clientele includes Pfizer, Gavi, the Vaccine Alliance, which spearheaded vaccine funding and distribution efforts during the COVID-19 crisis, a role also played by the United Nations Foundation, another Mercury client. Gilead, another biblical name. Oh, there it is right there. There's an infographic. There's Mr. Wiles. And there's Trump. See, like I'm saying, Mr. Wiles is the mediator, the spirit medium between Trump and the gods. It's right here. I didn't even see this before I started making the video, all right? I just came across this as I'm making this video, showing something I've already said. This is the spirit medium between Trump and the gods and the pharmakia. All right, the pharmakia. Monsanto, otherwise known as pharmakia. There's always something strange going on with these people. This is the Politico article here. The most feared and least known political operative in America, Mr. Wiles. Wiles helped dismantle Ron DeSantis and salvaged the Trump. Is she a MAGA hero or an enemy of democracy? The Ice Maiden. Just like, what's that one? Thatcher was the iron something, the Iron Lady. That's a dude. Look at the face. Let's get a close-up on that face. See, the thing is they layer so much clothing, it's hard to see the bone structure. You just got to look at the face. There's Reagan. There's that photo we saw before. A little bit of an Adam's apple thing going on there, huh? Yeah, estrogen would explain the feminine appearance. Susan Wiles and her daughters. Not so sure these are daughters. They could be sons. Now, who's the grandma in this photo? And speaking of shadow queens, Tulsi Gabbard. All right, you hear the voice. The voice is lower than mine.
Because this man has the courage to take them on and root out the deep rot of corruption in the swamp in Washington.
And look at this one.
I won't take up much of your time, but I do want to tell you the main reasons I am voting for Donald Trump.
All right, that's normal speed.
Number one, immigration. He mentioned it.
Number one, immigration. He mentioned it. It's the same pitch as my voice, more or less, right?
I'll be thinking about her tomorrow all day.
I'll be thinking about her tomorrow all day. It's the same pitch. It's impossible. In fact, let me tell you this. Megyn Kelly was the first transvestite I noticed on television back in 2015. It was a debate with Trump, and Megyn Kelly was moderating. So Megyn back then was kind of hard on Trump, but now is like on Team Trump. Kind of interesting how these things happen. So I knew about Caitlyn Jenner propaganda with an agenda attached to it, and then I saw this entity here, but I still didn't really connect the dots until later on when I saw another one on TV, and then I realized, oh, there's more of them. See, this was like the first one I saw on TV. So I was like, oh, okay, there's one. And then I saw another one. And I was like, oh, there's more. And there, it's kind of getting that anorexic look, but it's just a man. It's a man with low body fat. Look at those shoulders. Come on. How many women do you know with the voice? Basically the same voice as mine. And huge, massive shoulders like this. And all kinds of surgery on the face. And then it's at this rally, it's doing the androgyny symbolism, bearing the one breast. There ain't no way that's a woman, right? It's for me, in my opinion. Now, you guys can disagree. The trolls can leave their stupid little troll comments. Whatever you guys need to do to get through the day, do what you got to do. All right? It's a bipartisan deception going on here, all right? Both sides do this. I think Orson Welles pretty much explained it. Whenever that interview was, like in the 70s or 80s, you know what was going on. I'm not sure exactly what he meant by all that, but maybe he's thinking, you know, there's some kind of weird supernatural thing going on in the government. There just is, right? These people are like, they're practicing sorcery, right? This is the occult. They're not just like, they don't have gender dysphoria. There is Freemasonry is what it is. God is ultimately sovereign over these things, and God chooses the government, really. And the government is used to either bless us or curse us. Governments can be good or they can be evil. And a lot of it depends on us. You know, it probably is true. Maybe that's what Orson Welles was trying to say, in fact, that the old saying, we get the government we deserve. So I guess this is what we deserve. We're getting what we deserve, man. Hey,